Now I am going to explain Laplace transform of a signal. Laplace transform of x of t is given by x of s is equal to integration from minus infinity plus infinity x of t raised to minus st dt, where s is a complex frequency, is equal to sigma plus j omega. Sigma is attenuation constant. There are some limitations of Fourier transform. The limitations are, first one is ft does not exist for unstable signals. Stability of pole zero cannot be studied. The differential equations with initial conditions cannot be solved. Little difficult to calculate convolution. So there is some necessity of LT, it's called need of LT. Here solution of differential equation becomes simple. Discontinuous signal can be solved. Knowledge of both magnitude and frequency can be obtained. So now I will define what is ROC. ROC is region of convergence. It is the range of values of sigma for which x of s attains some finite value. There are some properties of ROC. First one is ROC does not contain any pole. Second one, causal signal has ROC, extends to the right of the rightmost pole. For non-causal signal, has ROC, extends left of the leftmost pole. If the x of t is two-sided signal, then ROC is a strip bounded by poles. ROC of LDS system contains imaginary axis. Finite duration sequences has ROC entire S-plane. So there are some problems on LT, to find LT, ROC is poles and zero. That is, first one is x of t is impulse signal. Second one is unit step signal. Third one is ramp signal. Fourth one is exponent signal. So Laplace transform of ramp signal, that is impulse signal, is only one. And Laplace transform of the unit step signal is 1 by s. Laplace transform of the ramp signal is 1 by s square. And Laplace transform of exponential signal is 1 by s plus a. So these are the ROCs of the different problem. So if the given signal is two-sided, then you will get x of s equal to 1 by s plus a, 1 by s minus a, where ROC is sigma minus greater than a, and other ROC is sigma less than b. This is a strip in the S-plane. So next, some of the properties of Laplace transform. One is the linearity property. Second one is time shift property. Third one is time reversal property. Fourth one is time scaling property. Fifth one is frequency shift property. And next is integration property, frequency differentiation property, convolution property, initial value theorem, and final value theorem. Next, we will study inverse Laplace transform and application of Laplace transform. So suppose, for example, inverse Laplace transform of differential equation d by dt y of t plus y phi into y of t is equal to x of t with initial value y of 0 plus is equal to minus 2. So for this, if you apply Laplace transform, you get the equation y of s is equal to y of s is equal to 3 by s plus 2 minus 2 by s plus 4. Then you have to use partial fraction expansion method then to find a and b, a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 1. Therefore, overall y of s equal to 1 by s plus 2 minus 1 by s plus 5 minus 2 by s plus 5 is equal to 1 by s plus 2 minus 3 by s plus 5. Apply inverse Laplace transform to this, you will get y of t is equal to e raised to minus 2t minus e raised to minus 5t u of t. Next, to find the transfer function and impulse response of the differential equation 5 d by dt y of t plus 10 y of t is equal to 2x of t, assume initial value is equal to 0. Then applying Laplace transform to this equation, you will get 5 s y of s plus 10 y of s is equal to x of s. Then you will get y s by x of s is equal to 2 by 5 s plus 2. This x of s is called y s by x of s is equal to 2 by 5 s plus, this is the transfer function. If you apply inverse Laplace transform to the transfer function, you will get the impulse signal 2 by 5 e raised to minus 2 t u of t. At the right moment, Z transform. That is, Z transform is applied for a discrete time signal. that is Z transform of x of n is equal to x of z is equal to summation from n is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n z raised to minus 1. There are some again RZ properties here also. So it's same as Laplace transform. Finite right sided sequence has ROC outside of the rightmost pole circle and infinite. Infinite causal left sided sequence has ROC inside the leftmost pole circle and in infinite two sided sequence ROC is a ring in Z plane. Next ROC does not contain any pole and for finite right sided sequence ROC is entire Z plane except at Z is equal to 0. For left sided sequence again ROC is at Z is equal to infinity and entire Z plane. Next one is for two sided sequence ROC is entire Z plane except at Z is equal to 0 and Z is equal to minus infinity. Properties of linearity. So there are some properties of transform again same as the Laplace transform, linearity property, time shifting property, convolution property, time reversible property, differentiation property, initial value theorem, final value theorem. So some Z transform ROC and Z plus 0 of x of n is equal to exponent signal, x of n is equal to left sided exponent signal. Therefore, x of z is equal to, if apply this, we will get 1 divided by 1 minus z raised to minus 1, where ROC is, as to z raised to minus 1 is less than 1, or a less than 0, or z is greater than 1. We will get this is the ROC, and there are pole at z is equal to n, 0 at z is equal to 0. Similarly, for second minus b raised to n, u of minus n minus 1, x of z is equal, we will get z divided by z minus b, but ROC is, here z is less than b. Poles is z is equal to b, and 0, z is equal to 0. And then we can find IZT by two methods. One is by long division method and partial fraction expansion method. So first we will solve the IZT by partial fraction expansion method. So for x of z is equal to this equation, for condition is z is greater than 1, magnitude of z is less than 1 by 3 and magnitude of z is in between 1 and 1 by 3. So x of z by z is equal to this one. Then we can use partial fraction and we'll get a is equal to minus 1 by 2, b is equal to 1 by 2. Then we get x of z is equal to this equation. Then we apply to find the sequence x of n. There are three, first condition z is greater than 1. Then it is a right sided sequence. Therefore, x of n is equal to minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 raised to n plus 1 by 2 raised to u of n. That is raised to n u of n. Second condition is for z is less than 3, we will get left sided. Therefore, x of n is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 raised to n minus 1 by 2. And whole bracket d of n minus 1. For two sided sequence 1 by 3 less than magnitude z less than 1, x of n is the first one is right sided, next one is left sided, you get this answer. Next, IZT by long division method or power series method. Again, the condition is this given equation is this, and z is less than 2 and z is greater than 2. For z is less than 2, arrange the numerator and denominator by ascending order of their powers. Therefore, they are given by z divided by 1 minus 3z plus 2z cube. Then if you solve, you will get z plus 3z square plus 7z cube. Therefore, x of n is given by left sided 0, 1, 3, 7, like that, dash, dash, dash. And if z is greater than 1 by 2, arrange numerator and denominator in descending order. Therefore, you will get z divided by 2z square minus 3z plus 1. If you go on dividing, you will get 1 by 2z raised to minus 1 plus 3 by 4z raised to minus 2 plus and dash. Therefore, x of n is equal to 0, 1 by 2, 3 by 4, dash n. So, this completes the Z transform.